I work as a night janitor at the local high school. I would 95% of the time be the only one working the night shift because there wasn't really a need for more than one. I always start with the downstairs classrooms and work my way up to the upstairs classrooms. The cafeteria, gym, auditorium, nurse's office, those were all responsibilities of the morning and afternoon guys. So since I was always alone, I would commonly have a bunch of radios sitting around the hallways playing loud music, like I did this one night. The upstairs of the school was shaped like a U rather than an O, so to go around to the other side, there was only one way. I was mopping the floor in one of the social studies classrooms when I noticed, from all the way across the other side of the school, the lights to one of the classrooms turned on. I don't mean it was left on. I always shut the lights to every room I wasn't in. I mean the lights turned on. I stood there with chills running through my body. There was somebody walking over to the window. They stopped and stared straight over to me through the window. It was the most disturbing thing I had ever witnessed. I didn't know what to do. Confront them? Run away? Call the police? I got closer to the window. It was somebody who looked like they were in their 30s or 40s. He had black hair, and I could see a lot of facial hair. He raised his hand and began slowly waving at me. I pulled the blinds to the room shut and tried to catch my breath. Tried to sort out my options. When I lifted the blinds back up, the light from the room across the school was off. My heart went back into panic mode. He was surely on his way over to this classroom. Right then, the option to run seemed best, and so I did. I ran down the stairs and out the back door of the school, not giving a second damn about anything but me and my life. Security cameras revealed that sometime in the night, the man emerged from the basement of the school and began wandering around. Getting a closer look at his face, I could see just how disturbed it made me feel. He was not a pleasant-looking man. The creepiest thing, though, was the camera revealed him going back down into the basement and never coming out. He was never found down there, though, which makes me question if there's some hidden rooms or exits down there. Lately, doing this job has never been more terrifying.